Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome back to Twist Gaming. We are here streaming to you live from Origins 2019, bringing you a front row seat to all of the great convention coverage and the new and exciting board games that are being announced. I am here with my friends Megan and Jesse from Asmodee.
Hello.
Hi, everybody. How's it going?
And you guys have brought me a new game to check out and some new upcoming news to share.
Mm-hmm.
I want to thank you both very much for taking time to be over here. I know you guys are super busy. The convention is super busy. And it means a lot that you've taken time out of your day to come hang out with me. So thank you very much.
Well, thank you for having us. We're excited to be here and show off some awesome new games.
Mm-hmm. Awesome.
So, yeah.
So, Megan, what did you bring for me to see?
We brought Mega City Oceania.
So, before we get too far into this, big disclosure that this is very much so a prototype copy of the game, prototype components, but which is awesome because that's how early we're getting to hear about this new great game.
Giving you a sneak peek.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. So, yes, prototype components, of course, but they're still pretty good. We've got some pretty plastic pieces. So, this is a game from Hub Games.
Okay.
It's a city building game with some light dexterity elements. So you'll be building stuff. This is not a legal building within the rules of the game, but just for the
example,
this is my person. I mean, you can take the components out and play with them in any way you want.
It's your game.
Right? But you're going to be building things and then moving them into this big mega city that we're all building together.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So Josh had asked if there was a little bit of a dexterity aspect to it, and I'm assuming that's a little bit of, and not entirely dex, but that's what you were demonstrating there with how you had the building pieces, and it was don't knock over the building.
Yeah, don't knock over the building. That's the main element.
Don't knock over the building, and then like some cards like have restrictions for what pieces you can use and how you lay them out, so it gets a little trickier the more you go through the game. Mm-hmm. But
so how, take me through a round
how
this works.
All right.
Sure. Okay, let's say Jesse's first player, so we'll start with some pieces to give us an edge up.
Sure.
But he can do a number of different actions. So he can take two standard actions and some things he can do. He can come to this bag here and draw three random pieces.
And I'm going to do that.
So it comes with
all these pieces, all differently cut, differently shaped.
Let me throw a couple of those.
Yeah, of course, do that. And so these are different materials. So they're going to be stone, glass, and metal.
Mm-hmm.
And so all of these materials are used to build different buildings. The plans you have for buildings can be restricted by the type of material you draw.
Mm-hmm.
You can draw three random or one specific. So if you need that one,
you really need a glass piece.
Yep.
They're super irregularly shaped.
Yep.
Yes.
Yep.
And that's the fun. You get to draw some pretty
wacky. For all of your
wacky
building frustration fun.
Yes.
Yeah, so other things I can do, so I now have materials, but I don't have a contract, so each game is set up depending on the player count. There's a specific number of contracts you can take, and these dictate what you're going to build and how you're going to put it into the city. So, for
do
instance...
Do you want to grab one?
Yeah, let's do that.
Go through the card?
So I'm going to go that one.
Yeah.
So that's red. So then that has to be placed on a red hex, and these are all on here, correct?
Yes.
And that has to be at least 40 millimeters high, and we have our handy-dandy measurer there.
Oh, look at that.
And you can measure that on there. So it has to be at least 40 high, and then there have to be at least 6-plus pieces. So I have to use at least 6 of any shape, any style.
In this case, exactly 6. Some will
exactly
say
5-plus,
6-plus, but this one has to be exactly 6.
Okay.
Thank you. And I have to half cover the vent or the power source. Mm-hmm. Is that a power source or a vent?
That's the vent. Yeah.
That is the vent. I have to. Each tile has a vent that you normally do not cover, but this wants me to cover half of it.
So, for instance, you might be able to build on this zone. It's a residential, a red zone, and because of the contract tells you to cover the vent, you would have to cover
that
up
these.
That's the blue.
The blue one.
So the blue, the pentagon, hexagon.
That's
a
hexagon.
I know shapes.
Gaming's favorite shape.
And so the little circles you're seeing are the power sources. So you have to cover all of them up unless your card says so, because your buildings need power.
Makes sense.
Yeah. So that. So all of the contracts are different. And it's variable based on hex type of materials you use and how tall they have to be.
Okay.
So I'm going to take that. That's another action I can do. You can only do two per turn, correct?
Two standard actions.
Yep. Other things you can do are take hexes to add to your tableau, little building tableau, before you put it in the city.
Mm-hmm.
And What else am I missing?
So let's say you already have a zone that you've taken. Then, as an action, you can flip it to the other side. And then it is Ooh. The color of what the vent on the opposite side would be. So you can kind of preview. Yeah.
So this one is the purple, and that's here. Okay. Mm-hmm. And then orange.
Right. So even if there isn't, let's say you needed a purple one and you only had orange out here, well, you could still take an orange zone because you know that on the other side, if you flip it, it's going to be purple.
Makes sense.
Yep. Mm-hmm. But that does cost an action. So Jesse took his two actions.
Yep. So now I have kind of like a blueprint, if you will. See what I did there?
Thank you, Jay-Z.
To start building there. And then it's going to go to Megan's turn.
Yep.
Now, let me ask you, you had mentioned before, we're starting off with tiles that look very different from mm-hmm. the city tiles mm-hmm. that we originally had, and this is not going to go in. Mm-hmm.
No, it's green. So it's green screen will not work. But, these are parks. So you start with a central park in the middle, and that's where everything has to connect to every building you ever put in there. But you have an option on your turn if you're placing a building in the city. You can include a park, and that would give you some extra cultural points if you place a monument there. Ooh. And if you place a monument, that would just be, you know.
Adds even more points.
Yeah, right? A piece.
Yeah.
Yeah. Look, what a beautiful stone. Yeah. Sir, so steel monument.
People will come from far and wide to see it.
The artistic inspiration behind that one.
Thank you. Thank you. Yes.
That's about right.
I worked very
yeah.
hard with my team of sculptors.
It's really, I feel your soul mm-hmm. that you've put into it.
Black as night. Yes.
Yeah. So, wow.
Black
okay.
as steel. All right.
Okay.
Back
so
into the game.
It's gonna be that at your yep. core, that's your core. You're taking pieces. You're taking contracts. You're taking hexes to all fulfill the contracts.
Mm-hmm.
Where the game gets a uniqueness from is during your turn, there's really no downtime because I'm going to be building stuff and finagling stuff while Megan and you are taking your turns.
Mm-hmm.
Because one of the other actions is once you have all the pieces and have these completed,
right.
one action you can do is once it's all complete, you slide it in without having them knock over.
How do you do that, Jesse?
Like,
I was waiting for you to make the building.
Oh, yeah, you have to have a building.
I knew that. I was just being me.
Yeah.
All right, so we're going to just do this. We're going
to
just...
So the building does not make it to the park.
Yeah.
Well, then you got to build it again. You can't have a broken building in your city. So, yeah, so let's say Jesse does something kind of precarious. And you never do that. He's trying. He didn't make it very far. If any pieces that's fall, that's no longer a legal building.
Never happens.
So his turn is over. He has to try and build it again.
So does he have to wait another turn in order mm-hmm. to get to it? Oh.
But there's no downtime because you're building in between turns.
So then now I'm going to, like, if I did knock it over, now I'll, you know, be like, okay, mm-hmm.
you get
I need
redesign
to rethink this.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, exactly. So let's see if I can actually get
now
this.
Now he's committed.
Yes.
Yeah, now I'm good.
And every time you build something and commit it to the city, if it's the tallest building at the time, you get a bonus point. So you would mark it with that little marker that says, this is the tallest skyscraper in the
Yay!
Whole place.
You have the Sears Tower.
Yeah, and that's just another way to get more of these. Also prototype.
Yeah, of course, definitely.
But these nice prestige points that will eventually win you the game if you have the most. And of course, tiebreaker is tallest building because what a feat.
Yeah. So I can imagine the analysis process and the engineering that goes into this. Is this a longer game? Is this where's playtime right now? And obviously we're prototype and
right.
what have you.
Box says 45 to 60 minutes. And I'd say that's pretty true for my couple of playthroughs. I mean, if you get caught, you know, maybe we're stuck on Jesse because he's still finagling and it's his turn and he made it.
And it's on the end.
But are you
forever.
Covering the vent?
That's fine.
That's
great.
Okay. Don't worry about it. We won't worry about the specifics of the contract.
No.
Yeah, but they would be concerned that they asked for something and you didn't deliver.
Yeah. There we go.
One fun part is at the end of the game. You've got this beautiful, just so many buildings, and then
what is
knocking it over.
What is end condition?
End conditioning condition is when you run out of standard contracts.
Yeah.
And then there's an end game where you can build landmarks. Mm-hmm. So there's some final capstone element to that. And you would also lose points if you have too many of these. You lose points for having leftover materials.
Okay.
How wasteful. Lots of ways you can win points, but also some things you have to consider before you get to the end.
So there's not yet a set release date for the game.
Quarter three. Thanks. Is what I can tell you.
And how do people find out more information on the game and when the release date becomes set? Learn about that as well.
Well, you can certainly follow Asmodee USA on our social media channels to keep up to date, right at the minute.
Yep.
But we also have our Asmodee website, AsmodeeNA.com.
Yep. And then Hub Games also will have information,
yes.
But release date stuff will be primarily Asmodee NA, Asmodee US.
Perfect.
Yes.
So you guys are down at the convention hall now.
Yes.
Which booth are you at?
735.
And you guys, which games are you demoing downstairs?
So we'll have this one. Sometimes they get switched in and out. We've also got some great new games from Libelude.
Yep.
The makers of Mysterium,
yep.
Of course.
We've got it's called Obscurio, and that's been hopping all day. So Obscurio, we couldn't bring it out. We only have one copy. And we couldn't rip it away from the demoers because they were like, no, you can't take this.
These people demand this game.
So essentially what it is in the stylistic form of a lot of Libelude games with beautiful art that you're trying to guess and there's a clue giver. That all aspect is there. But there's a twist. There's a traitor in your midst.
Mm-hmm. I like the twist.
And
yeah.
And then so you're not only trying to escape and figure out the puzzles in there, but you're also trying to rat out the traitor mm-hmm. because once you rat out the traitor, you have a better chance of moving on.
Yep.
And there is not even player elimination, so when you figure it out, the traitor still gets to mess with your game
mm-hmm.
and usually prevails. But no, sometimes you beat them, sometimes you don't. It's a really super fun one. We're going to have a lot of demos of that at Gen Con.
Mm-hmm.
But if you're here at Origins, please check it out. It's one thing that has had lines all day, and people are really excited about it.
And so are we.
We played like 3 hours last night in the lobby.
Yeah,
so
oh, that's
two games.
Really cool.
Yeah, if you're in the Hilton downtown, we'll be playing tonight.
Yeah.
So come check it out.
Very cool.
Yeah, so we've got that. Other stuff we've got on the tables. Z-Man has a new pandemic, rapid mm-hmm. response.
Yes, we were fortunate enough
yep.
to get a first look
Did
at
you?
That
All right, perfect.
Yesterday, the day
yep.
before.
Mm-hmm.
So that is a really fun
anxiety-inducing.
Simultaneous
so
anxiety-inducing,
yeah.
you know, simultaneous rolling, chaotic, all the good things in pandemic, but, you know,
real time.
Ramp up the
Dice.
Tension, add you a little bit more crazy.
Yep.
Yeah. So that's a really fun one. Other stuff we've got. We've got Catan as everything and anything Catan you could ever want.
Mm-hmm.
We've got Incas,
Crop Trust,
all their new scenarios.
Game of Thrones.
Yeah, Game
yep.
of Thrones stuff. Just won the party game. It's up for Spiel. That's thank you from the team at Ripo. That's out on the floor and new stuff from Plaid Hat. Abomination yep. Frankenstein. The Heir of Frankenstein.
Mm-hmm.
What is that?
Me.
So that is Victorian London. You're racing. It's like a worker placement, and you're trying to build an abomination. And the resources are bits and pieces of cadavers, as you do. You know,
but it's a very uplifting theme.
Yeah. The interesting mechanic there is you can go get an arm or a leg, but as your turns progress, as cadaver pieces happen to, they rot.
They rot,
and you have to get back and put it all together before it rots, and
mm-hmm.
it's very thematic and really spooky, and, you know, people have been super excited. That's another Gen Con,
mm-hmm.
Aiming for Gen Con release, so, yeah.
Very cool. And so I heard you guys have one more piece of news regarding a retailer program.
We do,
all
of you retailers and people who go to retail stores. So we just announced our Asmo Play program, and I have a kit hot off the presses here. So these kits are going to be 6 kits per year, every other month, and if you're in our bestsellers program, which is our top 40 line, you're eligible to get this for free.
Mm-hmm.
And inside, each box is themed and it has centered around 5 different games in our titles that we know and love, and sometimes they're new, sometimes they're classic favorites. And you open it up, and in this beautiful box is even more beautiful boxes.
We love boxes.
Yeah. And so in each one of these boxes, there will be promos for that you can't get anywhere else that are, you know, very unique and stuff that we've crafted to generate, you know, hype and excitement for a casual play program.
Mm-hmm.
So we have our very well-known organized play program, but feedback from retailers we got was to have more casual play things. So once you have an event, you get all these cool promos, and instead of everybody fighting over one promo, there's enough for everybody to take one home.
Sharing is caring.
Yeah. So this is coming out end of July, early August. So that will be the first kit. So look for that and talk to your sales rep if you're interested. They are free if you're in our best sellers program.
Awesome.
And also, all the information you could ever want is on our AsmoPlay website, asmodina.com/AsmoPlay. One more look. Here we go.
It's beautiful.
It's beautiful. Thank you.
Megan, Jesse, thank you so much for taking time out of your day to come and hang out with me and share with me all the cool stuff. I really appreciate it. And I look forward to having you guys on again.
Awesome.
Of course.
Thank you. It's always a pleasure. Always fun. Thank you, guys.
Folks, and stay tuned. Oh, go ahead.
No. Thanks for watching, and I'm going to have you do the outro.
Stay tuned. We'll be right back with more great board game coverage. Bye.